taking care of Hershey and my little Hershey dog, our little Hershey dog. He had some ailments in his time. He had two hip surgeries. 9 years old. I said to somebody one time about my dog, you know, he's supposed to be a blessed dog. Why is he having these surgeries? And they said, well, he is blessed because he'd be a dead dog if he wasn't your dog. This dog, seriously, I'm not kidding, has cost us over $10,000. We love the dog, okay? But his little hips were not working like they should. He wasn't able to jump like he should. Now, he still played, and he was good, and he had a few good years left in him. Yes, he did. But his little hips weren't working like they had before. He had a skin condition where his skin was really itchy. We had to give him baths, and you know, it'd get all scratchy and itchy, and he'd go and, you know, move himself on the floor trying to, you know, get relief from his itching. His little eyes were matting. We were having to put drops in his eyes. And he's going deaf. Okay? And all of a sudden, I'm like, seriously, this is all going on as I'm talking to Jesus, as he's helping me see differently, as he's helping my heart become whole. All of a sudden, Hershey doesn't have itchy skin anymore. Hershey can hear just as clear as he did before. His eyes aren't matting, and we don't have to put medicine in him all the time. And he can jump and play just like he did when he was a little puppy. And I began to see, it's like an eternal perspective started coming in my mind. Instead of me focusing on why didn't it work out the way I wanted it to, why didn't you heal him the way I wanted you to, why didn't you raise him from the dead, all of a sudden he's alive. And I heard the Spirit of God say to me, death, where is your victory? Death, where is your sting? Death is swallowed up in victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. And I remember what he told me a few weeks earlier. He said to me, Connie, there is no such thing as death for the believer. See, we go through loss in this life, and it's called death to us. But people don't die. They just take a trip back home. There is no such thing as death for the believer. This body that I live in, it's not really me. If I just, you know, tomorrow was gone, I'm still alive. I'm still alive, whole and healthy, and never, ever experience pain or heartache or tears again. What a wonderful promise from a Savior who loved us, died and rose again. Not only is that we can have joy and peace and victory in this earth, but so that for all eternity, we will never experience heartache or pain or brokenness or sickness again. He loves us. He loves us. So as I'm getting my own heart, you know, this 2 hours in my bed before I have to go tell my girls, I'm getting my own heart, like, help me, Jesus. Go in and tell my girls, okay? Me and my husband, about 7:30, decided, okay, it's time to go in and tell my girls. So we're in the bedroom, and we tell them Hershey didn't make it. My Kristen breaks down again in a heap of crying. My Victoria, on the other hand, does not shed a tear. She crosses her arms like this. She goes in the hallway away from us, and she sits down on her bottom, and she sits like this. Doesn't say a word. I'm looking over at her going, oh my goodness, what's going on? You know, what is going on in her heart? I look at Kristen. She's just completely shattered and heartbroken. And I'm going, Jesus, help us, help us, help us. Pretty soon, Victoria gets up off the floor. She comes in there and she sits down and she said, a lot of good our prayers did. We prayed and God didn't answer our prayers. Why did we even pray in the first place? She was blame shifting. Guess where her blame shift was going? To God. It's God's fault. He didn't answer our prayers. Why do we even pray? Kristen, on the other hand, blame shifted to people. Why wasn't he taken care of well enough? Why didn't the vets do more for him? I, on the other hand, dealt with, why didn't I tell them to put him on a leash? Why did I not take him with us? Why did I not why. Realizing in this whole scenario, when we go through hard times, when we go through a dark place in our lives, one of the temptations we have is to blame shift. Somebody's got to be at fault here. Because somehow if somebody's at fault and we can figure out who's at fault, it makes us feel better somehow. No, it doesn't. It doesn't make us feel better if we can figure out that God's to blame. It doesn't make us feel better if we blame someone else. It doesn't make us feel better if we blame ourselves. Not blaming does not heal. The truth is, we're without fault in God's sight. And I had to keep saying, Lord, I don't know why I didn't do that. And I don't know why I didn't do that. And I even had a moment. I remember when I was leaving, just a moment, and it was very slight and light about Hershey. And it was just, I just remember it being something, a concern for him. But I dismissed it and just walked away from it. And you know what I'm saying? And I think, oh, why didn't I take care of that then? And then I thought to myself, if you come to Bible study like 6 months ago, I had a miracle with my Hershey. His arm was stuck to the right, you know, out, and I couldn't get it to come back. And I just put my hands on it and spoke life to it and said, Jesus, help us. And that little puppy just perked up and jumped up and did a little dance around my room. And I was just like, oh my goodness, 6 months ago. But this time, I thought, oh my goodness. You know what I'm saying? You go through all of these things going, well, I didn't. I didn't respond that way. I didn't respond the way I did back then. Maybe if I would have responded differently, it would have turned out differently. I had to have Jesus just again soothe my heart. And my sweet Jessica, who is married to my son Justin, she was the rock in the room. She was the Jesus with skin on in the room. And she just kept pointing our minds to Hershey's happy, he's healthy, he's running, he's playing, we'll see him again. She just kept bringing our minds back. Jesus was using her, bringing our minds back to that which would be our only comfort. There is no other comfort in this situation than to see Hershey not dead, but alive. You know, and some people go, yeah, whatever. Some people don't even believe animals, when they die, go to heaven. I don't care what anybody believes. I know what my Jesus showed me. I know the comfort that I have in my heart. I know he loves me enough that my Hershey is there. And I know when I get there, he is going to run up to me like he did every single day when I walked in the house. And jump up on my lap and want love and bring joy like he did the 9 years that we had him in our home. Now, as I'm sitting there on the couch with my girls, again, the blame shifting was going on a little bit. And I remember in Psalm 23, where it says, he anoints our head with oil. And I began to pray. I said, Father, I thank you that you have been anointing my head with oil. You've been helping you. You've been rubbing my feet and helping me see clearly and getting my mind on internal perspective. Help my girls. I need you to help my girls. I don't want them to go through life thinking they can't trust you. I don't want them to go through life thinking that you're not good. And so I'm praying this underneath my breath as we're all experiencing this grief and this sadness. And after we had been there for about 2 or 3 hours, hugging each other, loving on each other, talking about Hershey, and I go and I lay down in my bed in my room, and I'm laying there, and I'm still just, you know, Jesus, help me, strengthen me, renew my strength, restore my soul. My Victoria, she comes into the room. She sits down on the bed. Now remember, she's the one that was blaming God. She was the one that was doing this thing. She sits down on the bed and she looks at me and she says, Mama, you know what I was just thinking? I said, what, honey? And she goes, we should be happy for Hershey. He's healthy and happy and running and playing, and he'll never itch anymore. His eyes won't mat anymore. His hips work right now, Mom. We should be happy for Hershey. Instead of sad that we don't have him, happy that he's whole and healed. And I'm looking at this young girl, this 14-year-old girl, who 2-3 hours ago was doing this. And I'm like, Jesus, you're rubbing her legs. You're helping her to stand. You're giving her eternal perspective. Because no matter how much we all sit there and said, Hershey's in heaven. He's running and playing. He's okay. You know what? If the Spirit of God doesn't give you revelation of that, you can go, who cares that he's in heaven? I want him with me. It's true. So it takes a revelation, the anointing of the Holy Spirit, to be able to cause individually Victoria's mind and Kristen's mind and Tony's mind and my mind to come to a place of peace in a hard situation. One of the conversations I had with my Kristen later after we came home.
The struggle is real. Life happens to all of us. But there's a better way to live. It is for freedom that Christ has set us free. Because of Jesus Ministries invites you to a Women of Grace conference. Experience powerful, grace-filled messages from Connie Witter, Nicole Marbach, Trisha Gunn, Gwen Myrie, Shannon Orr, Sherry Reether, and Christy Rose. Come be with us in Birmingham, Alabama, Branson, Missouri, Sioux Falls, South Dakota, Morton, Illinois, Chicago, Illinois, Orlando, Florida, and Broken Arrow, Oklahoma.
You're free. You're free. Remember that you're free. You're free from fear. You're free from condemnation. You're free from guilt. You're free from trying to earn God's favor. You're free.
For more information or to register, go to womenofgrace.us or call 918-994-6500. We look forward to seeing you there.
Home. And she seemed to be doing better. I mean, she was sad. She had her moments. But then it was interesting to watch her too, because she went from blaming a person. And then she said to me one day, she says, Mom, why didn't God answer our prayers? So, you know, she went from here and then to here. I mean, all of these things. It's the same thing that was happening to me. I'd go in one spot and I'd have to be, Jesus, help me. And then I'd go here, and Jesus, help me. And then I'd go here. Why didn't God answer our prayers? And she goes, I don't see how any good can come from this. She said, you say that God turns all things together for good. And she goes, I don't see how good can come from this at all. And I said to her, I said, Kristen, I said, God can turn any bad situation into something good, but unless you believe that, you won't see it. Unless you believe the promise that God turns all things, every detail of our life, into something good, you won't see it. And I shared with her how people in this world go through hard things. They go through really hard things. And I said, we either respond in one of two ways. We respond by saying, Jesus, help me see truth in this. Help me come out stronger in this. Or we reject God. And I said, and sometimes it's not even, I don't believe in Jesus anymore. It's just the rest of your life. You have this underlying thing that you can't trust God. You really can't trust God. What's the use of praying? Because he ain't going to answer my prayers anyway. And I said, and you don't live a good, happy, fulfilled, peaceful life. I said, so the choice we have before us, is God good? Is God good? Does he love us? Yes. Will he turn all things together for our good? Yes, he will. And when you believe that, you begin to see it. And one of the things that I saw just right at first was that this is the good thing. And I do not believe it was God's will for Hershey to die. So I don't believe that. I don't care what anybody thinks. I don't believe it. I don't understand it. But I don't believe it, okay? But the first thing I saw good coming out of this was me being able to talk to my two girls about a hard thing such as this, a loss that we really haven't experienced before. Like I told you last week, we experience a lot of Jesus answering our prayers. I mean, I pray with my girls a lot. I pray with my sons a lot. We see God's glory all the time show up. We do. This was like the first really hard thing where it was like it didn't turn out the way we thought it was going to turn out. And I got to walk through this with my girls, helping them to see from an eternal perspective, helping them to see that even when things don't turn out the way we think they should, we got to let go of the blame game. We got to let go of blaming ourselves, blaming others, blaming God, and just embrace His love and His truth to strengthen us in our dark times. And so I just told Kristen, I said, Kristen, that's the choice you have right now in your life, and you'll make it again, and you'll make it again, and you'll make it again. I told my boys one time, one of my boys that I was talking to, he was going through a really hard time. I hope this doesn't offend you when I say this, but I told my son, everybody deals with crap in their lives. Everybody does. It's how you respond to it that determines the quality of your life. Everybody's car breaks down. Everybody faces lack at times. Everybody experiences loss. Everybody does. We all do. We live in this world and we all have experienced hard things that we don't understand. We've all been stolen from or somebody's betrayed us, rejected us. We all have crap happen. Right? It's how we respond in those moments that determines the quality of our lives. Will we bleep, 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 bleep? Or will we, I don't care what anybody says. God is not good. He should have done it my way. I can't trust Him. His promises aren't true. Or we can go through that process of, Lord, help me. Help me renew my mind. Help me to see this from your perspective. I don't know why it didn't turn out the way I hoped it would. I don't get that. I will never understand it. But I'm going to let it go. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not to your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge Him, and He will make your path straight. One of the things that sheep do if they're left to themselves, is they create ruts. They go around in the same circle, in the same paths, until the pathway that they have been going on is completely barren. They, left to themselves, have destructive habits. They self-destruct. Sheep in the natural will self-destruct. And people sheep, if they go their own way, guess what they do? Yeah. Self-destruct. It's just amazing to me. It is so amazing to me to realize we need a shepherd. We need a savior. We need somebody to restore our hearts, to restore our mind, to restore our soul, and lead us down a path of righteousness for His name's sake. I'm going to tell you the last little thing. There's been plenty more of conversations with God and my children and how God has restored our hearts and given us an eternal perspective. And I told the girls, Hershey's on our future. Hershey is in our future. We're going to keep our mind on. We're going to see Hershey in the future. Every time we're sad, every time we're, you know, the doorbell rings and he doesn't bark, every time we come home and he's not running to us, remember, Hershey's in our future. And we're going to be with him forever and ever and ever. That's the only thing that's going to comfort us. It's the only thing that's going to make us strong. It's the only thing that reveals the love of God. Well, I just went on a weekend getaway with some friends last weekend. And we were sitting there and we were talking about Hershey. And 3 years ago, my daughter-in-law had a miscarriage. So I have a grandbaby in heaven. And one of my friends said, you know what I was thinking, Connie? I was thinking that your grandbaby and Hershey are playing together in heaven. And that was another one of those, you know, rubbing my legs, restoring. I was like, oh my goodness. Because one of my thoughts was, Hershey doesn't know anybody in heaven. He's going to be all by himself in heaven. That's the silliest thought you could ever imagine. But, you know, you go there. Wait a minute. We're here. We love Hershey. You know? And all of a sudden, I got, oh my goodness, one of us, one of our family is in heaven. Our little grandbaby playing with Hershey. And I got this picture, and I was like, oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Woo! Isn't he good? Oh my goodness. Woo, that's a long story. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Well, I'm just going to end real quickly with, wow, I had a lot more to say. He leads me in paths of righteousness, not for our earning it, but for his name's sake. And for his name's sake means maintaining one's reputation. His character, his glory, his opinion of us is manifested for the world to see. His goodness of heart toward us. He leads us in paths of righteousness. Now, imagine the paths of righteousness being the fruit of righteousness in your life. It's that peace that passes all understanding. It's that wisdom that you need in a situation. You know, when I'm dealing with a situation or talking to my girls about this situation, I have my own ideas, or I can let Jesus lead me down a path of righteousness and help me to minister to him what he has to say. Same way in a situation with my children as they've grown up. It's like, you know, you want to say this. It might have a little condemnation in it, what you want to say, you know? But when we look to Jesus to help us, in those situations when our heart is sad or discouraged or fearful, when we look to him, he renews our minds, he anoints our head, and he leads us down a path of righteousness where we are displaying his character, his comfort, his perspective into the situation. And it turns out, oh, so much better than our own destructive paths, our own ways of fixing things. Jesus has a way of turning, again, our ashes into beauty, our mourning into joy, our grief into joy, our despair into voices of praise. He puts a new song in our heart. I'm telling you what, all I know is this. I'm holding on to Jesus. He's the only peace I've ever found. He's the only joy that remains. He's the only one that makes me feel approved and loved all the time. I'm holding on to Jesus, and I know he loves me. He died to set us free. His love, if nothing else, you didn't get anything out of this message other than this. I want you to take this home. God does not prove his love for us by doing things our way. He proved his love for us by sending his son to make us righteous so that we could be whole. That's how he proved his love. We don't have to live in condemnation. We don't have to live in the blame game. We don't have to live with regrets. See, I could live with regret with this my whole life. I really could. I really could. There are some things I know I could have done to make the outcome different. I could have. It's the truth. I was talking to my friend Shannon. She was trying to lift me off of the, you know, I'm like, I gotta come to the conclusion that it could have been different. And it's okay. Woohoo! It's okay. I could have did some things different. It could have made the outcome different. But it's okay. I don't have to live in the regret of my past. I don't have to live blaming myself or anyone else or God. I can live free in the love of the Father, in the love of the Son, in the comfort of the Holy Spirit. And guess what? Out of this situation, I'll just be able to minister to more people, because the scripture says with that which he comforts us in our hard times, we're able to comfort others. That's one good thing that comes out of every bad situation is the compassion and the love of Jesus you have toward other people when they go through hard things too. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Awake to righteousness. You are qualified, innocent, forgiven, accepted, approved, and loved. Join Connie Witter as the journey through the book of Romans continues in Awake to Righteousness Volume 2 and be empowered by grace to live a righteous life. Available now, Awake to Righteousness Volumes 1 and 2. Also available as a group Bible study package. Call 918-994-6500 or visit ConnieWitter.com to order or download your copy today. Because of Jesus Ministries introduces our first children's storybook, Are You a Chickenhead? By Connie Witter. This fun little book asks the big life question, what's true about you?
Mommy, that girl called me a chickenhead.
Is that true, Victoria? Are you a chickenhead? What does Jesus say about you? For many years, I have shared this true story to encourage others to believe what Jesus says about them. I pray this book will inspire parents, grandparents, and children alike to confidently respond,
I believe what Jesus says about me.
Order this delightful book today. Call 918-994-6500 or go online at becauseofjesus.com where Bible studies are always in the light of Jesus. The struggle is real. Life happens to all of us. But there's a better way to live. It is for freedom that Christ has set us free. Because of Jesus Ministries invites you to a Women of Grace conference. Experience powerful, grace-filled messages from Connie Witter, Nicole Marbach, Trisha Gunn, Gwen Myrie, Shannon Orr, Sherry Reether, and Christy Rose. Come be with us in Birmingham, Alabama, Branson, Missouri, Sioux Falls, South Dakota, Morton, Illinois, Chicago, Illinois, Orlando, Florida, and Broken Arrow, Oklahoma.
You're free. You're free. Remember that you're free. You're free from fear. You're free from condemnation. You're free from guilt. You're free from trying to earn God's favor. You're free.
For more information or to register, go to womenofgrace.us or call 918-994-6500. We look forward to seeing you there.
Because of Jesus Ministries is your resource for grace-filled, Jesus-focused Bible studies and curriculum for all ages. Adult Bible studies, books, devotionals for girls and teens, DVDs, CDs, and MP3s. We offer group Bible study packages as well. Connect with us and check out our many free resources online at ConnieWitter.com, where Bible studies are always in the light of Jesus.